again, folks. Welcome to my channel. Now, for those of you who watch my paranormal videos at night, thank you. I have had a few comments that are quite, in my opinion, negative. These comments are suggesting that because I've got a lot of orbs happening, that the orbs are somehow fooling me, somehow tricking me, because it is of the devil. Because in the Bible it says that the devil will present himself as light. Now, I believe that we are all entitled to our own beliefs. If you are a Hindu, you're entitled to believe in reincarnation. If you're a Muslim, you're entitled to believe in jinns. If you're a Baha'i, Baha'is believe in ghosts and things. And if you're a Christian, you're entitled to think it's demonic spirits as well. But I wanted to explain, to make it quite clear, several things. Number one, I'm a psychic medium. Now, for those of you with a Christian or religious bent, that's immediately rings alarm bells, because psychic mediums, in the Bible, there's a place where it says about witchcraft and about talking to the dead. So already you believe I'm in touch with Satan, that Satan has got his little claws into me. Well, if that's true, and I'm a psychic medium, and Satan has got his little claws in me, why then add an extra layer of sending orbs to me when I'm already under Satan's spell? Do you understand the irony? I'm already there. If I'm a psychic medium, I wouldn't need, and if I'm a psychic medium already been tricked by devil, why go? I don't think the devil's got time, you know, to be doing this every night. You know, Jem's already under his spell. She's a psychic medium. So why would he send me beautiful orbs? Number two, I have been a psychic medium since the age of 8, 9, 10. And I am very much in tune. Just like there are good and bad in what we do, there are entities all around us that are neither, that are good, and that are bad. And I have cleared hauntings. I've done many clearings. So I've come across some darkness. And sometimes in poltergeist activity, sometimes we think, for example, that that is really evil. Like, I think the German word poltergeist means just noisy ghost. And that's, take it literally. If I came back as a ghost, I would think it absolutely hilarious that you're in the shower and I went boo or threw something at you. So I'm full of mischief. So maybe not all poltergeists are demons and darkness, but it could be mischievous entities who just think it's funny. I also want to share with you that from the age of 10, I suffered very badly with sleep paralysis. In fact, in my 20s and 30s, I was having at least one attack a week. And at the time, I didn't know it. I thought it was some form of epilepsy. I would have this pressure on my chest. I'd be paralyzed. And I knew there was something, you know, on the peripheral of my vision. There was something there. There was something wanting to hurt me. I never saw a hag or a hat man, but there was something wrong. And I couldn't breathe, and there were times, you know, you try to scream, wake up your partner, and thought I was going to die. I've even had an episode where I've been astral traveling and woken up during the astral travel and found myself levitating. Now, at all that particular time, I was into Christianity, and did I go through some trauma? Because I can remember telling my minister about this, and yes, it's demonic possession. I have seen all sorts of entities. I've seen entities that you've got to understand that the evil entities, they get off on fear. Well, even if you're mischievous, you'd get off on fear too, because you'd think that's pretty funny. But you've got to, some entities are like bullies, and the more you fear them, the worse it gets. And it is true, the more you acknowledge an entity, the stronger it gets. So the more I say to my orbs, beloveds, the more they're going to interact back to me. That is true. But also, to put your minds at ease, every day, when it comes to the end of the day, I say a little prayer. And for me, I don't believe in a Christian God, but I do believe in divine, perfect love from which we all come from. So I go through and say, you know, I am sorry for the things I have done wrong today. I am sorry for the bad thoughts I've had. And I've asked for help and for healing and to be a better me for the next day. And then I ask for that for people in my life. And then I ask for that for the world, you know, for love and light for the world. And then before I do my paranormal videos, I ask to be protected, and I ask for beings that vibrate at the higher frequency. And the higher frequency than us is love. It's only at these low, dense frequencies that we get negativity and hatred and evil. And if I've also gone around and smudged my place and told that all evil, toxicity and negativity must flee this place. So I've smudged it, and I still have my beautiful orbs. Also, around where the motion detector light gets triggered, there is a crystal, there is a dream catcher made by the Navajo Indians, and it's got all the chakras in it. So I am very well protected. So I am just really replying to people who are getting really upset. Well, number one, you don't have to watch my video, okay? And if my video is really scaring you because I'm saying they're my beloveds, they are my beloveds, they've make me a better me. I go along and I have a really stressful, horrible day. It might be full of drama. And I love the Balinese saying, you bring drama, you get karma. But anyway, I might have had an off day with an institution. Institutions full of people. So I've had, you know, moments of anger and irritability. And all these orbs bring me peace, and they make me want to do better and be better, and they bring me peace. I have healing. I haven't had nightmares. I haven't, but there again, that particular Christian person would say, who commented that, you know, I'm getting sucked in, that I'm just being sucked in. But that to me doesn't make sense, as I said, because I do seances, I do automatic writing, I do channeling. So I'm already, if that Christian person wants to go there, in Satan's clutches. So if I'm already in Satan's clutches, he wouldn't have to do this extra work and send me orbs now, would he? That's a bit ironic and ridiculous. So I'm just responding to the comments, but everyone has a right to what they feel is going on in my life. And I'm very grateful that people are so concerned for my well-being. Thank you. Thank you. But as I said, this is not dangerous. This is a very loving. I have people who come into my home and say how harmonious, how loving it is. And it's because of the spirits here. And I specifically ask for spirits that vibrate at a higher frequency of love and light. So they vibrate at a higher frequency. Fallen angels don't. Fallen angels vibrate at a lower frequency. Yes, yes, you're right. Demons can pretend to be anything. I once saw an entity that was, what's the word for it? Plaguing my husband who died. My husband actually went white. I drew a picture of what I saw, and he had never described it. And he said, that thing has what I saw when I was 10 years old. And what it presented was like a bear demon thing with big fangs. But it showed me three faces. And one particular face it showed me had sores and runny, you know, to try to get me repulsed and revolted. And you've got to remember that demons, by the way, and don't have all horns and ugly and you know, or look monsters. If you are a Christian, you well know that Lucifer was the most beautiful angel. So, yes, if we are being deceived, we will be deceived by beauty. I once was abducted by an alien, and this was in one of my videos that I had did last year, talking about an alien abduction in Canberra. And I asked to see the form, and the alien telepathically said to me that if I saw what it looked like, I would be so horrified that I would just be overcome with fear. And it said to me that we have it wrong. We think that things that are beautiful are good, and if they look ugly, or if they look repulsive or whatever, or horrible or awful, that they are inherently bad. And that's not the case. And my son and I have a little joke and said, what if angels were cockroaches? Could you see them little cockroaches coming down with little wings saying, we bring you love? I'm just kidding here. But what happens if our saviors were ugly like cockroaches? I mean, we're all squeamish at cockroaches, but you know, if you believe in this savior stuff, we don't know what it looked like. We just think that things, if they're beautiful, that they're good. But please, please understand that I have years under my belt to ascertain I know what's truthful, and I am not being deceived by Satan. Because as I said, if I'm a psychic medium, he's already got me. So why would he send orbs? Does that make sense? Not to me, it doesn't. All right, I'm going to love yous and leave yous and do another paranormal later tonight. Talking about that, I might get my phone and see what we get on one of the apps. Hey, we haven't done that for a while. All right. Cherish every moment. Every life matters. Love the best you can. Love you. Video done. Bye.